We want to determine the equation of the line passing through the points 3, 1, and 5, negative 1. And we want the equation to be in slope-intercept form. Where slope-intercept form is y equals mx plus b, and m is the slope of the line, and b is the y-intercept of the line. Now we could use point-slope form of a line to help us determine this equation, which we will do in a future video, but right now we're only going to be using slope-intercept form. So we'll start by determining the slope. Remember, if we have two points on a line, we can determine the slope of the line by using the formula m equals y sub 2 minus y sub 1 divided by x sub 2 minus x sub 1, where these are the y-coordinates and these are the x-coordinates. So let's start by finding the slope. Let these be the ones and these be the twos. So this will be x sub 1, y sub 1, x sub 2, and y sub 2. So we'd have m equals negative 1 minus 1 all over 5 minus 3. So we're going to have negative 2 divided by positive 2, which is equal to negative 1. So now that we know the slope, we know that y must equal negative 1x plus b. And we'll simplify negative 1x later. Now let's determine the y-intercept. Looking at the two given points, neither of these are the y-intercepts because notice the x-coordinates are not 0. But since these two points are on the line, that means these coordinates must satisfy the equation, meaning if we substitute one of the x values here and the corresponding y value here, the left side must equal the right side, which will allow us to determine b. So let's determine the value of b by using this first point here with coordinates 3, 1. So we'll substitute 3 for x and 1 for y. So we would have positive 1 must equal negative 1 times 3 plus b. And since we have one unknown, we can now solve for b. We have 1 equals negative 3 plus b. So we'll add 3 to both sides of the equation. So we have b equals 4, which is our y-intercept. So now we can substitute 4 for b, and this would be the equation of the line. We would have y equals negative 1 times x plus 4. Now normally you won't see the equation left in this form. Negative 1 times x would just be negative x. So let's go ahead and write this again as y equals negative x plus 4. Now let's take a moment and verify this graphically. We were given these two points. This point had the coordinates 3, 1. And this point had the coordinates 5, negative 1. And we found the equation of this line to be y equals negative x plus 4, which remember is the same thing as y equals negative 1x plus 4. So by looking at this line, let's quickly verify that the slope is equal to negative 1 or negative 1 over 1, and the y-intercept is positive 4. Well, this blue line passing through the given two points does have a y-intercept of positive 4. And then notice that if we select any point on this line with integer coordinates, let's say this point here, if we move down one unit and right one unit, we do end up back on the blue line. And notice that we had a vertical change of negative 1 and a horizontal change of positive 1, which does verify the slope would be negative 1 over 1 or just negative 1. So this does verify that our equation is correct.